Melissa was one of the strongest tropical cyclones ever recorded in the Atlantic. Peak winds nearly doubled in intensity in just 24 hours over the weekend.
Meteorologist Heather Waldman is here to explain some of the factors that may have helped the storm explode in strength.
Yeah, Melissa first became a hurricane with peak winds of 75 miles per hour at 11 o'clock on Saturday morning. Just 24 hours later, eyewall winds were estimated to be 140 miles per hour, nearly doubling in strength. And of course, the storm was on the way to 185 mile per hour estimated maximum winds just before landfall in Jamaica early yesterday morning. We call this rapid intensification, and it's happened to three other storms in the Atlantic so far this year. There's a couple large-scale patterns that may be making this more likely in the future. Let's start with La Nina. We're in a weak La Nina right now, and that's defined by cooler than normal water temperatures in the tropical eastern Pacific. But La Nina also has impacts in the tropical Atlantic. That's mainly a decrease in high altitude winds, the trade winds that blow from east to west. That reduces what we call wind shear. And wind shear is when it's high in areas where hurricanes commonly develop, the hurricanes don't hold together quite so well. So storms tend to maintain or gain strength in areas with weaker wind shear. Now let's talk about climate change, because that also likely played a role in Melissa's strength. According to NOAA and NASA research, oceans trap more than 90% of the excess heat that's generated by increasing greenhouse gases. That raises water temperatures around the world. And satellite data shows that the water where Melissa strengthened the other day was 2 to 3 degrees warmer than the long-term average. 80-degree water temperature is prime fuel for hurricanes. Melissa was over water temperatures 85 to 87 degrees, and that warm water went down close to 300 feet in some spots. So even though the slow-moving storm was churning up cooler water, as these storms do, it had huge stores of warm water to work with, allowing it to keep getting stronger even as it was nearly stationary. Now, to be clear, climate change and La Nina on their own did not cause Hurricane Melissa. It would have been a dangerous storm on its own, but warmer oceans and a warmer atmosphere increased the potential for more of these rapidly intensifying storms in the future. Back to you.